Everybody, it's Evicta. It's time for a regular Blue Baby run by popular request. A couple people in the mosh pit in the last couple of days have been asking for regular Blue Baby. They said they've been having problems going through the regular campaign before they get to the tainted side with Blue Baby, and he can be kind of difficult, so I've got no problem trying it out for you. Thank you all very much for supporting the videos. Yesterday's video did not cross 5,000 likes yet, but the previous ones did indeed, and again, I'm keeping an eye on those like streak counters from the other day. One's currently sitting at 6,800, the other was at 6,400. So we're currently 104 out of 120, I believe, anyway, that's correct. Thank you all very much. Hope your Fridays have started off great, and hopefully the new year's treating you well so far. Here's your meme of the day. This one brought to you by the boss 113201. Title thread was, "It gets Grandpa's seal of approval." Oh, Grandpa, oh. Yep. That's about as good as it gets. Thank you very much, the boss, and all 36 of you upvoted that one. So, regular Blue Baby, let's hop on in. Interesting run we got today, hopefully. Today's going to be 3 Victor Hotel, November, X-Ray Quebec, 1-3. So, regular Blue Baby is a character I've not played in a long, long, long time. But he does start off with decent damage, does start off with decent tiers rate as well. Of course, the biggest problem for a lot of newer players when you're playing as regular Blue Baby, not Tainted Blue Baby, regular Blue Baby, is the fact that, of course, you get no red hearts, period. So you cannot, any HP up that you get is basically going to turn into a soul heart. Now, that's good and bad. The first time that when you play Isaac and you see Blue Baby for the first time, you think like, wow, this is the hardest character in existence. How can you even possibly win with this? I can't. You're telling me that every hit that I take is permanent, unless if I get a soul heart. Like that's asinine. That's madness. But when you stop to think about, you know, the base stats of Blue Baby are very good. He's got good starting speed, good starting damage, good starting tiers rate. You know, his survivability is problematic, especially when you have, if you have a penchant for going into, or if you have a knack for going into curse rooms early on. You know, you got to be careful with that. But the biggest concern, of course, is taking devil deals. Now, with the way that repentance changed for angel deals, you can accomplish quite a lot with just going angel deals. And one of the plus sides, and I think that this is one of the biggest things that people tend to overlook when you're talking about Blue Baby in general, is the fact that you cannot take red heart damage, period. You literally cannot. You know why? Because he's got no red hearts to take damage from. You know, so you're going to be completely fine in terms of being able to qualify for any angel deal and any devil deal that you want. I mean, you got it, brother and sister, you got it. But obviously, you know, you can go for devil deals, especially if you have an early game surplus of soul hearts, which is kind of rare, especially by floor two. But I recommend, unless if you are in the scenario where you have a bunch of soul hearts, I highly recommend you go for angel deals. Just go for angel deals. That's all you got to do. Basically, no way we have the means of getting out of here without taking a hit there. We barely scraped by. If you go back and play that in slow-mo, you'll notice that I shot one of those spiders right as I was passing by it, and that gave us just a little bit of separation between me and them, so we didn't take any damage from that. So, also, by the way, shout out to this ginormous floor one that we have not found either the item room or the shop on. It's pretty cool. Pretty awesome. We have 1, 2, 3 XL rooms, so that's good.
Neat.
And as plain as the day is long, we are going to finally be able to find our shop adjacent from our item room. And yeah, I mean, Burkomiosis is quite good. And if we can get one more scent here, that will allow us to get this bomb chest, which may be the keys to the kingdom here. But we got to get one more penny. Apparently there's a penny over here. How did I miss this? Me? Oh, yeah, that's why. Me missed something 7 times? No. No, not me. Not the professional Isaac player. You see here, we get a little bit of... It's kind of like sinus infection away. If we can get the explosions off, they do a very good amount of poison damage, and they also spread, kind of like contagion. You see the mushroom, the fungus shots there. Yeah, there we go. And if they explode directly on the target, all those shots will hit and deal a massive amount of damage. We get consolation prize, which gave us a troll bomb, of course, instead of a regular bomb or anything else that would have been useful. We do get a tears up. Unfortunately, we're going to have to leave the bomb chest behind unless we go into the curse room, which I really don't want to do. I don't think there's any fires that we left behind. Yeah, we're just gonna have to end it. We did get a child's drawing, so technically speaking, we have 1 of 3 for Guppy. Good start. So I always try to stay out of the XL rooms as much as possible. Whenever I can, you know, they're annoying to deal with, and they also tend to be dangerous. Yeah, here you go. There's the explosion that we want. Blue Baby also starts off with a poop. I think that if you wanted to buff Blue Baby, oh, you jerk. If you wanted to buff Blue Baby, like if there's ever a need for a buff, which I don't think there is, but if you ever really wanted to, you could start him with Petrified Poop, and I think that would answer a lot of people's concerns that they have. But, you know, it's at the end of the day, in my opinion, I think that Blue Baby is quite good. You do just have to be very cautious. I mean, I was just like you once. I also felt the same way in terms of having this overwhelming dread of playing this character just because of how difficult it was to cope with the fact that you're like, hey, you know, every piece of damage that I take is permanent unless if I find a soul heart. You know, these red heart upgrades are basically worthless. I mean, there's nothing that we can do with them. And if you think of it outside of the box in a more positive way of saying, like, well, not positive, it's more strategical way. There's nothing wrong with being with, you know, thinking critical about a character. But if you think of it more from a strategical point of view and understand the fact that, hey, not having to worry about taking red heart damage is super duper good. Like really, really good. Oh, I wasn't planning on that hitting our donation machine, but got some bombs here. I mean, we probably should stick with the burnt penny over child's drawing, because we're not gonna go devil deals. We're going angel deals, so. Hey, here's one card. Now, I didn't actually mean to buy that either, but I'm glad we did. Secret room should be here. We also have a tinted Raku. Glad I shot that, because I don't think that would have hit. Get a judgment card. No reason for me to play this right now. We don't have enough HP to really matter. Plus, we don't need to worry about blowing up any beggars or anything like that, because we're not going for the 100% deal with the devil here. But yeah, I mean, if you really wanted to help out people who are struggling with regular Blue Baby, you could give them Petrified Poop to start with. I think that the poop as a starting item is pretty lame, to be honest. Or if you wanted to, just give them a passive that gives them a slight chance to get payouts from using the poop, better than like most. Give them like a 50-50 chance to get like, or maybe not 50, like a 20% chance to get like a coin or something. You know, not soul hearts, but something amazing. Like maybe like a 1% chance for a soul heart. Murkomyosis, mycosis, urkosis. Doing some work there, and boy howdy, what a good drop that was. We can double our keys. Another Hierophant, pretty good. So we got our judgment card, a temperance machine, another temperance machine. You know, for the cost of one bomb, we can make a pretty big splash here and even possibly get our could get our bomb back with these coins that we're gonna make. I mean, we got one of them back, so hey, look at this. Now we do have quite a bit of soul hearts. We could go deal with the devil. Oh no, never mind. No, we can't. Yeah, I think we're gonna stick with this and head on down. Could use a bomb here to try to blow up these four mushrooms. I'm not going to, though, because it's our last bomb, and the likelihood of us getting anything out of these mushrooms are very, very, it's minute. But as you can see here, I mean, we're still doing okay for damage, but we really need to start. I mean, we have to hope that we get a good, well, first off, we have to hope that we qualify for an angel deal here before, like, you know, floor five. Secondly, a damage upgrade would be pretty nice. Now, because we have options is going to help us out greatly. You know, we did pay a bomb for it inside the store, but how did that? Oh, we hit the creep. You know, but the fact that we got basically nothing out of our second boss was kind of lame. So we need something. We need something a little bit stronger than chemical peel here. Ooh. Are you kidding me? I thought for sure that was gonna hit. There we go. All right. Well, we got Guppy's paw. Now I really feel dumb for losing our child's drawing, because we would be 2-3 Guppy. That's actually kind of ridiculous. Without getting devil deals. Eternal heart, okay. Again, it's only good for one soul heart, so it's not that big of a deal. I have a feeling our shop is probably gonna be below the secret room, maybe. This is what you really want. You want these enemies to kind of clump up for Mercomyosis, Mitosis, Psilosis. There we go. Yeah, they, when they cluster up like that, it's bad news bears for them. Good news bears for us, bad news bears for them. Okay, let's take this smartly. There's no reason to ignore the wall crawlers over here. These are much easier to deal with than the creepy spreaders over there. 11 keys now, quite a bit of keys. And oh baby, keeper sack, let's freaking go! And a random soul heart, bro. Sign me up. Down for that. Absolutely. 0.97 damage up, and just you know, complain about repentance all you want, which I have and still do, probably more often than I should. But you know, I got complaints. However, some of the items that we've gotten in Repentance are just so damn good. And I apologize for using harsh language, but it is true. It is so good to have stuff that gives you stats for doing what you would have been doing anyway. Not requiring us to take any damage at all. That was an amazing dodge, by the way. Not requiring us to take any damage, not requiring us to lose anything. We're simply just gaining more stats for stuff that we've already established that we were going to do anyway, which is buy stuff from the store throughout an entire run. And, you know, there are a lot of bad items. There's a lot of bad changes in Repentance, but at the same time, we get some good items, and Keeper Sack is just one of them. It's just one of those hard carry items that every time you see it, every time you get it, you know you're going to get taken care of. If you manage your money wisely, you're going to get taken care of. Squeezy. You're gonna give us two more soul hearts and a tears up. Unfortunately, no angel deal. No surprise there, but I will be a little bit peeved if we don't get one on the next floor. So, Curse of Lost, 68%. Obviously, we're gonna be prioritizing all of our damage. Or all of our funds into... That was too close. All our time into getting as much money as possible. I didn't think those flies are going to travel that far up. I thought they were going to cut a little bit right there. Like once they hit the wall. I'm very happy that we stuck with a burnt penny, however. That's going to be huge. Technically speaking, there's no real reason to break the poop in here until after you've already cleared the room. You can fire across this gap and the dingles can literally do nothing to you. The dingle on the other side of the room, that is. There we go. Look at that poison spread. So good. You can get the shot off as well. This is one of those rooms where if you move too quickly in one direction, the Globins will automatically counter your direction and basically just swarm you, unless you have flying or if you're just fast enough. So just pausing a little bit when you walk into a room, into that room particularly, is going to benefit you greatly, because you get to make them make the first move and then you can dodge. You can dodge a lot easier than they can dodge You can dodge them a lot easier. Keeper's Bargain would be good, especially for Keeper's Sack, but the problem is that we don't have enough money right now. I knew that was going to explode at that time. So because of the presence of Keeper's Sack, now we have a greater importance on knowing how to find secret rooms whenever we can. And that is a very important skill to have. It's one that I've talked about for many years now, is being able to find the secret rooms, even on Curse of the Lost, when you literally cannot see anything. So secret rooms, the regular secret room anyway, we're not talking about super secret room, we're just talking about regular secret room. The regular secret room cannot be adjacent to a skinny room. However, it can be at the end of a skinny room if it's going up against a flat wall, basically. So that's what told me that there cannot be a secret room here, even though typically if you see this room here, the secret room is normally located on this left wall here. Sometimes to the north if it's the super secret room, but typically it's located there. That's the reason why you didn't see me place a bomb there or there. I know that the secret room is not there because if we go check out for confirmation in this room, there cannot be a doorway there. So the secret room will never, almost never, in 99.9% of the time, because Repentance kind of changed the rules a little bit, but 99.9% of the time, the secret room can never spawn where a door cannot. Okay, so if there's any room that has a doorway where the secret room would be, but it's an impossible doorway, that means the secret room cannot possibly be there. Same thing goes over here. This is the room that's, I'd say, 80% of the time you see the secret room to the left of this tile. However, if you go into this room here, you'll notice that this is a skinny room, which means that the doorway would have to be here. And as I just got done saying, the only place that a secret room can spawn anywhere adjacent to a skinny room is at the end, either there or there. So just wanted to clear that up. And we get Rotten Tomato. Rotten Tomato. It's definitely one of my more rising contenders to be great support items. You know, just being able to aggro, just having things run into each other is just so good. I mean, you know, it's along the same lines as Sissy as well. You know, whenever enemies are just charmed, they just kind of just run right into each other. You know, they take care of themselves, essentially. You just sit back and just watch the mayhem unfold. I do get another bomb here. Yeah, look at that. Fungal shot taking care of Larry. We do find the shop. Unfortunately, we don't have a lot of money, so you can really only buy a soul heart, and that's about it. Yeah, so notice how the needles are just hopping after the one that we painted with the Rotten Tomato. By God. 7-cent ladder wouldn't be bad. The reason is because even though it's half price, it does count as a full premium item. And we would get full credit for that stats-wise. So we definitely are very, very motivated to find one more penny. Now, the only unfortunate thing here, we have a little bit of an anti-synergy between Rotten Tomato and the Fungal Shot. Because if you notice, whenever it procs with a red fungus cluster, whatever you want to call it, among us cluster, it does not apply the paint like it would a normal shot, so that's a little bit unfortunate. We're not gonna get a penny, are we? Super secret room is north of here. Now the super secret room is completely different than the regular secret room. Super secret rooms can only be adjacent from one and only one room. The only reason why I know it's up here is because I've seen this tile a billion times. Maybe not a billion, but definitely like over like 10,000 times. And I am a little bit more than angry at the fact that the secret room, or that the fortune telling machine did not give us anything. So here, this is a little bit of an exception to the rule here, because I don't think there was a room to this, to the right over there, over here. Yeah, there wasn't. So this is a little bit of an exception to the rule. Sometimes the secret room, I cannot believe that we didn't get a penny. Sometimes the secret room can be located on the elbow of a room like that. And you notice how there's this gap here, meaning that there's no possible room over there, which means that's where the elbow is. Did not give us anything. I thought that would increase it to 100% devil or angel deal chance, but three soul hearts for one penny is pretty horrible. We did get movement speed and a little bit of range, but that was, I was hoping we were going to get damage out of that. But we have a 73% chance for a deal with the angels. Surely this means that we're going to be taken care of, right? Oh, good. It's everyone's favorite boss. Favorite boss, Bambino. Love Bambino. He's my favorite boss. Just want that poison to start ticking away here. And 73% deal with the devil. Burm, 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 burm. Deal with the angel. Whatever. You know what I meant. And, yeah. There you go. A floor 5 angel room. Boy, howdy. So awesome. Really neat. Gotta love it. So we get another tiers up, which is good for DPS. And it's good because we have, like, you know, actual tier effects that apply actual good effects. But we've gotten to the point now where we need damage badly. 4.65 is not going to cut it. So this is where we really need to rely upon the strength of Keeper Sack. Sorry? We really need to rely upon the strength of Keeper Sack to see us through here. Now, I know that the secret room is north of here because of two reasons. First off, I've seen this room, again, tens of thousands of times. Secondly, I've seen this room tens of thousands of times. And if you notice right here, if you see this inverted arrow, this is something I've talked about that people made fun of me for, but I still talk about it anyway because it's true. If you look at this as an inverted arrow, see how it's pointing over here? But look at this wall here. Notice how it's bringing all your attention to this flat wall in between these two steel blocks. And there's a little note here, which doesn't usually mean much, but I know that the secret room is definitely not there because I am not ever talking about secret rooms ever again, because every time I try to make a point like that, even though it's 100% true 100% of the time, the 1% of the time it's not, it's never there. So just don't listen to me ever again. The secret room is supposed to be there. Let's put it that way. I'm not the one who's wrong. It's the game and the children who are wrong. That's like a 95% chance for the secret room to be there. I'm just going to point that out. Ask anyone who's ever played this game as long as I have, or even as close to as long as I have, they'll tell you that the secret room is supposed to be there. Which means that this secret room on this level in particular is probably located in a really weird spot. We know it can't be there. How do we know that? Because if you go back into this room here, there's no wall here. Yeah, that works. I'm telling you, it's supposed to be here. In fact, I'm going to blow up these two skulls and leave it like that just to prove my point. So we don't know what kind of rune this is, but we can get two bombs for this. Oh boy, a Burcano rune. Neat. We know that there can't be a door down below here. Actually, there technically could be a door right here. So technically, there could be a secret room there. We're not going to check. We have four bombs, but we need to be a little bit cautious with our bombs. Secret room technically could be there as well. And this is looking more likely now. If you look at this room, notice how the skull is kind of like a tip of an arrow making from the rocks here. Starting to become a little bit more likely. Yep. Yippers. And this is gonna end up being one of those weird secret rooms where it's only adjacent to 5 rooms instead of 6. So we get the mulligan. Soul Boo Baby. I mean, we can use it against the boss, I guess, but we're not gaining any soul hearts right now. And we've taken a little bit more damage than I would have liked. Mulligan's going to give us a chance to get an attack fly every time we attack. We successfully shoot an enemy. Now, this is a good place here to invest some bombs into. Because of all these skulls, we theoretically should get one black soul heart. Theoretically. Theoretically, you should be getting, you know, 73% of the angel deals 73% of the times when you get 73% chance. Theoretically. Yeah, so I painted that dark silkworm there. That's a bag. I don't think the poop has actually given us anything yet. Now, we could have bombed our way into here, but I'm not going to do that. We did not get a nickel out of that, unfortunately. I'm not buying Little Baggy. A reverse chariot card, which gave us damage, and a soul heart, which gave us range and movement speed, slightly. We can use the chariot card against the boss. So the Super Secret Room could be in two places. It could be here, and it could be there. Get a nice range upgrade. Boy, sensor. I'd honestly rather just have the Bible. And we have no way of destroying the angel statue, unfortunately. So let's go back and get the sun card, and we will head on down. We're on the cusp of a good run here. Just not quite. Not quite a good run. If we can get enough money, and I mean, we should buy something out of here, but I'm not going to. Theoretically, here's the Super Secret Room, by the way. This one is 100%. But we don't have a bomb, so maybe we can find a coin or something. I could also go hit that mimic chest, which I... Okay. Was not ready to fight Super Gluttony, but hey, here we are. There we go. We get lard. I will take lard. It is just two soul hearts, but hey. It kills our movement speed, but we also got two bombs out of that chest, so allow me to prove to you that the Super Secret Room is right here. 100%, 110% guaranteed. Hey, you know what? That was worth it. That was worth. We'll take it. We will take it. So we're going to leave here with the sun card, lots of HP, and the Bibble. Going to go in the big room here and rip the sun card. Okay, so we can get into the curse room half price. We might as well go do that now. We will have a full charge on the Bible by the time we get to the mom fight, so I'm fine with that. I'm going to use the Bible now, so we gain a charge instead of using it afterward, where we would gain a charge, but it would be zero charges, basically. Yeah, this is kind of why I don't take Voodoo Head at all, because normally the curse rooms are just not worth it. Normally. With this fire rate and these tier effects, we should be mowing things over. But, you know, I mean, 5.5 damage is not the worst. It's not the best by any means. It's about average for what we would like to be. You know what? I'm going to use a vibe one here. It's going to be a little bit easier. We barely had enough damage there to stop that mom hand from retracting. We had another tears up in shot speed. And our tears rage is just busting right now. Might as well get a full card here. Never know when we need to exit somewhere. Full card would take us to the starting room of the level. And that is a credit card, and that is way better than a full card, because now if we do somehow, some way get a devil deal, we don't have to pay HP for it. Okay, so what we really want to do here, well, let's see what's in our store. Here's the problem. The problem is that I want to maximize our money chance from the Polaroid. Just restock too, man. But credit card makes it to where we get a free devil deal. Now, there's no guarantee that we're going to get a devil deal on this floor. So I think what we do... is we get restock, and then we get the Polaroid, use the full card after the mom fight, and go back if I can find it. Use the full card after the mom fight, get a couple of taps on that temperance machine, and then just try to get as much money as possible so we can boost our stats via Keeper's sack. The only risk here is that if we do get a devil deal, we risk not being able to get it again, or having to use the HP that we would have normally, that we would have wanted to use for the devil deal, or for the temperance machine, and use it for the devil deal instead. Either way, we have to take it. We have to take the devil deal here. No, I mean, that is a bona fide 100% fact. We have to take the devil deal here because our damage is not going to keep us alive. We're going to stay alive, but you know what I mean. Like, it's not going to be easy. Yeet. Yeah, we did not get a devil deal. I'm fine. I'm totally fine with that. Or
the fool.
Here's my theory. I want to take the negative to get a damage upgrade, and I also want a chance for this build to really fly. I'm talking fly. And if we get a victory lap with this base, we will be able to beat any boss in the game. So let's go get, let's get restock. Yeah, Joe, free, we could just take, if we get one more cent, we can actually get this, we actually get bottle of pills, which I'm not going to hold, but we can at least get it for the stats. Restock gave us a nice little bit of help. Gonna go ahead and just tap it once. Let's see what mom's bottle of pills gets us. Huge damage up. Oh man, come on now. You're gonna show me the mystery gift right next to the secret room. All right, let's do it. No, it's gonna take an astronomical amount. I'm gonna have to rip the credit card.
Credit card.
That would take an astronomical amount of HP. But Isaac's Tomb, all right. Isaac's Tomb is not bad. Gonna give us it will give us a free chest at the beginning of every level. As soon as I started seeing how much money we actually needed for mystery gift, yeah, no way I'm ripping that much HP. Yeah. So we have a long and lonely road to go before we get to our next store. Unless if we find the silver dollar on this floor, which is unlikely. Now, I know what you're saying. You're saying, and you just go down to Hush. We could go fight old Hushy, but without the Polaroid, with these stats, that's almost suicidal. Especially when we're talking about we're playing as Blue Baby. We've got substandard tiers. Okay, we get our soul heart there, I think. It only stays with us if we hold on to it. It's not worth the soul heart. I mean, Burnt Penny it's not better, but it's just better for us right now. Because we've been having some pretty decent luck at getting into secret rooms and having enough bombs to get into those secret rooms, or at least to facilitate the entrance into said secret rooms, is extremely important for Keeper Sack in our economy. So we definitely want to hold on to Burnt Penny here. Yeah, this does nothing for us. Maybe we get like Satanic Bible or something, and we can get two soul hearts out of that. And Skolex. We actually have enough tears rate to stop him midair. That's how fast we're firing right now. Even though it doesn't look like that. We do get a double deal. We do get a tears up as well. This is tough because we need soul hearts. No, we don't. Never mind. Yeah, I think we just go down to the next flow. Nice. Isaac's Tomb, one of those new fangled repentance items that are very good when you get it. I think you unlock it by beating Mother, or is it Greedier with Tainted Isaac, something like that. My God. Not gonna go into the curse room. Even for one soul heart, it's not worth it at this point. We've already established how bad curse rooms are. I tried my best to run right into that shot. Don't do that. Don't follow shots with your eyes. Follow where Isaac is, not where the shot is. More important to dodge the shot. Trust me. There you go. So you see there, the brimstone laser was aggroing the tech laser there and taking the heat off of us. Secret room might be there. Yeah. I think a 50-50. Again, people have asked me, where do I get these percentages from? How do I know what the percentage chances for a secret room being any given spot? It's completely arbitrary. It's made by me. But I do know where secret rooms are supposed to and not supposed to be. So just over the years, I've kind of developed a sort of like a number in my head that says, hey, you're supposed to be here, but it's not, or most of the time. And then I kind of go off of that, but it's totally arbitrary. At the end of the day, totally arbitrary. Yeah, it's about time you showed up. Petrified poop is going to be better for us than the burnt penny for the victory lap. If we do a victory lap. Super Serum might be... No, it can't be there. Never mind. It can't be there because this part was blocked off by poop. Enemies respawning over there, so... Yeet! A devil deal, no angel deal. Yeehaw. We'll take soul hearts all day, every day. Yeah, all we need to do is paint one of them. We have 5 luck as well, which is the reason why you're seeing all these procs, and it's beautiful. Also, we couldn't have gone to Old Hushy anyway because it's past 30 minutes. Yeah, look at the enemies do the work for us. Now that is where you want to be. Got full HP. Might as well do it. Maybe we'll get a good item out of here. Or get some bombs and money. It's fine, too. So they should just aggro each other right now. But they're not doing anything because, you know, I'm trying to prove a point. There we go. That's what we like to see. Yeah, just shoot each other point blank in the face. Now we're talking. Now Lust, now she's not going to do anything at all. Unless there was like, you know, there's another like Lust in here, then they would have just aggroed each other. So the invisible demon should have been going after the big explodey thing. I still don't know the names of those mobs, but you know, the big explodey things. Yeah, they should be aggroing each other here. Then they just yeet themselves out of existence. Secret room cannot be here because there's a little gap. Ooh, we get mom's ring. It's gonna give us just a straight up damage up. And Soul of the Lost. I mean, we could hold on to it for the... We can hold on to it for a devil deal, maybe. It's better than get out of jail free card. We're not really using get out of jail free card. I bought it just for the stats, basically. As in the stats that we get from Keeper Sack. It doesn't give us stats, you know what I mean. Now, the Super Secret Room could be here. This will illustrate my point that Secret Rooms can be at the end of these skinny rooms. It could have been there, but it's not. There we go. Again, just letting the enemies take care of themselves. Just happen to be in the direct line of fire of that brimstone laser. I have 17 bombs. Might as well look for a good tarot card or something. Maybe a reroll or not. Now, I think we can use the Soul of the Lost in the dark chest, I want to say. Okay. All right, it's time to play How Far Will Stanley Teleport Today? Yeah, I want to paint the bomb lampreys so Stanley goes after them instead and blows his foot up. And it spawned right on top of us. That was a neat trick. No soul heart for us, unfortunately. The Azer Raid, contract from below, Sanguine Bonds.
Soul of the Lost.
Soul of the Lost. It was the only one that was worth using, and I was correct that we did, that we were able to get it. We had Psyfly! Oh, sweet Jesus. Get me out of this room. Psyfly and Dead Onion. Dead Onion's going to be a big help for us as well. Look at that. Contract from Below just paid for itself, basically, in one room. There's Old Husky. Old Husky. Doing great, Psyfly. Yeah, I mean, Contract from Below just dominating right now, getting us double chest drops in three out of the four previous rooms. That's really, really good. Now, I know that it looks like whenever Rotten Tomato procs on an enemy, it looks like they're bleeding, but they're not actually taking any damage from it. How great would it be if Leech actually returned Soul Hearts? Now, that would be overpowered. And yeah, we don't want Marked or the D-Twizzle. Got the D-Wizzle. Sure. I mean, if we duplicate a chest in the chest, it's going to give us more chests. So, as in more items. So, sure, we'll take the D-Wizzle. Psyfly, great block there. Of course, ideally, we would just duplicate, like, you know, a couple Soul Hearts, too. That'd be fine. Of course, the D1 no longer guarantees whatever you're doubling, which is a very fun... That's one of those repentance changes that I will complain about. I wouldn't mind 9 lives if we could get it. And that would be ironic because we could have gotten Guppy without taking a devil deal. And there it is, so... The problem taking 9 lives now without having any other HP is the fact that we'll have to fight Lamb on 1 HP as Blue Baby. Not necessarily conducive with an easy task, but I've done it before and I can do it again. I just don't want to, but I will. Preferably, I really wish that Contract from Low would just give us like 2 Soul Hearts and then, you know, there's no more debate. Would have to be a mimic chest, wouldn't it? Here. Well, that's Guppy. With 9 lives, that is Guppy. Okay. We're gonna do it with 1 HP. Or at least die trying. I really wanted to wait until Kidney Stone had reset, but we've got Psyfly, so it gives me hope. And Guppy also helps out a lot. Oh yeah, also Lamb will aggro himself, so yeah, who was worried? Not me. Second run, 3 Whiskey, Charlie Papa, Zulu Hotel, 7 Victor. All right, we are Guppy and we are not re-rolling. No way, shape, or how. I straight up didn't even see that was a mimic chest until we got next to it. Shout out again to Repentance for that lovely change. Audio coin. We definitely could use some movement speed. $105 is, for the early stages, fine, but I think Eyesore gives us one additional tier, and if we do happen to get Tractor Beam, then that basically just gets turned into extra tiers, basically. Extra shots. Not even going to hesitate. Go here, we go here, we take that. More options for show. We could go compost with Guppy. I think the D1 is still better, though, to be honest. The D1 allows us to... Well, no, it's not. It's not. You know why? Because it doesn't give it... It does not guarantee us being able to replicate soul hearts. Now, Keeper Shop is interesting with Keeper Sack. But with us being Guppy here, yeah. Hey, Crackjacks. Oh, well, let's go say hi to Alt Path, shall we? I'm not going to stay on Alt Path because I don't really want to, but, you know, we can still have a little bit of fun here. We can kick the butt of some of these newfangled mobs. The compost just destroying things now. There we go, Isaac's Tomb. Didn't even see that death button there, but there it was. Wow. The mega chest to a diamonds. Here we go, and apparently compost does that. Okay. Compost? I'm gonna be real with you. I didn't know that you would take a mega chest away from me. And I'm not very happy about it. If you don't know what happened there, I used compost while not opening up the mega chest. And apparently that means that compost will just destroy it. Ooh. Ooh. Hoo-hoo. Now, that Fool card plus a Dice Shard means that we will get an extra pedestal at least inside of the Secret Room for us. And if I use the Two of Diamonds right now, we would get two quarters, two Mr. Booms, and that's four item pedestals if we use this Fool card. Yeah. And we're just going to pick everything back up. And then this dice shard will allow us to reroll the pedestals. Dice shard. Wow. That is about as disappointing as it could possibly have gotten. All right. Well, I mean, we got Shielded Tears, sure, and Rune Bag, you know, hey, nobody's perfect, but yikes. That was not a good reroll. It was a good plan. The plan was sound, but the reroll was not. Your mom's pearls yet again. I'll take Blood of the Martyr for show. That was a very good damage upgrade. And we are smoking now. And yes, I really should have opened up those. I should have destroyed those poop containers at the end there after Clog, but meh. Hey, don't use compost. See, the problem is that we've sacrificed all the stats we could have gotten from using Keeper Sack for Rune Bag and freaking whatever else we got. Shielded Tears. Another damage up here.
Soul of Bethan.
soul of Bethany. Okay. Okay. Oh yeah, brother. And the game crashed. Now, why would the game crash when we're just simply using Suplex? The only mod we've got right now is the external information mod, and that's it. So I think we're going to have to start Dross over again. Yep, okay. I don't remember what we got. I remember it was a whole lot of these chests. I know that we just got done doing this, but... yeah. Repentance. All right, we got our damage up. I'm not going to take Suplex. I just don't feel like having the game crash again, if that's what did it. So we're just going to go ahead and ignore it. Just trying to have a little bit of fun with Suplex, but not allowed. All right, we'll take Pandora's box here. Alabaster box is not terrible. We haven't taken a Devil Dew item, technically. So what does Alabaster box give us on floor four here? It will give us two soul hearts. Yeah. Apparently this counts as floor three. All right, never mind. Yeah, we could take Alabaster box. Need one more cent. Soul Will can give you Halo of Flies. I did not know that. That's amazing. I had no idea. We get Alabaster Box, which is going to give us two Angel Dew items, as long as we don't take a Devil Dew item. We don't even need to go Devil Dews now, because we've already gotten Guppy somehow. It's not every day you get to see a Devil Dealless Guppy. What happened to the mobs in here? Weren't there mob? You know what? I'm not even going to ask questions. Repentance. We're just gonna let it roll. Turdlet. More like Deadlet. Sure. Although I think we would have had, I'm pretty sure that would have given us a soul heart. Well, would it have given us a soul heart charge with Alabaster box if we just get a regular HP upgrade? I don't know. I'm gonna use our key here, but I'll grab Suplex just to be fair, but I'm not gonna take it. And that's what I get for looking at what time it is. You know what? We wanted Petrified Poop anyway. The time is currently 1:11 a.m. Brainworm is pretty pogged. Brainworm is essentially like Spoonbender. It's basically Spoonbender. With a much slower shot speed, but it is basically Spoonbender. We've got tons and tons of DPS now thanks to Kidney Stone. Kidney Stone, by the way, is going to fire out a boulder and then give us a massive amount of tears, as you see right here, for a short time as the duration kind of like slows down and decays after a little while. Soul of Maggie. Super Seed Room should be up here guaranteed. Exited the room a little bit too soon there. Sorry. My God. See, no, that's weird. Okay, so those of you who watched today's Thusmas, you'll see what I was talking about. There's an instance on Thusmas where we do have Alabaster Box, and I pick up a black heart, but it doesn't get allocated. But we just picked up a half soul, or we picked up a black heart there from the middle of that fire, and it gave us one credit for the Alabaster Box. Now, the only thing I can think of is the reason why is because whenever you take a black heart and you have a half soul heart, the black heart will repair that soul heart first before giving you the black heart. But we also got a black heart anyway, so I don't know, man. Take Fat on Mushroom here. That is going to give us it. Okay, so that does confirm that we do get a soul heart charge on the Alabaster Box if we get a regular HP upgrade as Blue Baby. Good to know. Unfortunately, Keeper is going to destroy our chance of getting more stats here thanks to Keeper's Sack. Don't really have a whole lot of money anyway, so it's not that big of a deal. And let's go rip the Alabaster Box here. Get Immaculate Heart as well as the Circle of Protection. And that is very, very good. I do like Immaculate Heart. It gives you a huge damage bonus. And overall, it's just a solid item. And then Circle of Protection, of course. You all know it. You all love it. It brings the ladies in. They all know it. They love the Circle Protection. They write home about it every day. Ooh, man. Digital Baphomet, we get Pogatory. And, oh, man, this run is... Now we're... I said it before. Now we're getting somewhere. Now I knew that this run could be pogged out. Now we're starting to pog. The Curse of Lost, hooray. More soul hearts than we can shake a stick at. Yeah, this is starting to get out of control real quickly. Sigil Baphomet, by the way, will give us a damage shield around Isaac every time we kill an enemy. And it will stack up to 2 seconds. It used to be infinite. That was nerfed, heavily nerfed, because it was just too dang powerful. But it is still quite the item. I'm gonna go ahead and purge the Curse of the Lost just because, you know, I mean, we're winning this run no matter what. Dead Onion and the piercing shots of Dead Onion here plus the Shielded Tears is just too good to have. Now we also have Host Hat, so, you know, we have explosion immunity, but again, just like we had earlier this week, where there was an instance of me having, I think it was the Greedier run, where I had explosion immunity but was still walking away from bombs, or I didn't go for, like, you know, Ipecac, that sort of thing. Like, if you notice right now, you would never be able to tell that we have Host Hat. Not by the visual indicator, not by looking at the item key on the right. There's no indication whether or not we have Host Hat. And the fact that, like, I never ever pay attention to whether or not, like, if it's basically out of sight, out of mind for me. So keep that in mind. You know, my point is that the visual indicator for Host Hat and, by extension, Pyromaniac is very easily overwritten by basically anything in the game. Anything that modifies Isaac's forehead in any which way. Actually, surprise is not there. Okay, good. The Super Secret Room cannot be there. Regular Secret Room, however, is there. I'm starting to get worried that we are going to come to a greed fight here. I'd be a little bit perturbed by another greed fight, considering we just got done getting done with a greed fight. And we haven't really been getting good stores to buy anything out of, and we have restock. And there's the greed fight. All right. You know what, game? You can keep those chests. Just keep all of them. Gish fight on top of another greed fight. And we'll go ahead and take safety pin. Head on down. Isaac's tomb, super good. That'd be a Perthro rune. That'd be an Alger's rune. What is up there? So this is a skinny room that you can find a super secret room at the end of. So there's the premier prime choice example right there. Right there, right there. I don't think it's there, but Justice is going to spawn us 4 chests. Useful for staying, for saving in the, oh, it's Ansa's rune. It's useful for saving for the chest. Like the chest. We can get out of boss rush with that fool card there. Or cement is going to be good, although the needle is not terrible either. Get black rune. More cards going to give us a crawl space. That's going to give us a... give us 2 of diamonds here. I am going to take PH Dizzle. I'm going to buy the blue candle. Well, I got to buy the blanket now. I should have used the 2 of diamonds beforehand. Why are we getting all hearts? I should have used the 2 of diamonds there. Get the D1 Hizzle. Not going to happen. I think we're just going to rip it, take that. We'll hold on to the candle, and then we're just going to black rune this stuff. We don't really need the tower card. So we got a 3 range and 4 shot speed upgrade. All right. Eight. We'll get our fool card from the cursed Tinted Skalu. That's... Yeah, rubber cement makes this pretty powerful now. Not that we weren't powerful already, but like the bouncing tears is just going to make it even more ridiculous. All right, 73% chance. Here we go. Get ready. He's done. Dark Bomb's pretty good. Pretty good for Blue Baby. And man, oh man, what a boss rush. The fool. You know what? Let's go see old Beastie. We don't need to go see Isaac today. Old Beastie. Plus, this also gives us 1 more chance at a shop. It can give us more movement speed, hopefully. Something of that nature. Eternal Harden there. We'll get it if we need it. Okay, good. Check down here, and okay, good. All right, so there's the northwestern and southern portions of the map, everybody. In case you were worried about what they look like, worry no longer. Okay, good. Hive Mizzle. Hive Mind plus Guppy is a very, very good combo. I just need 2 cents for Hive Mind, and that's going to jack up the damage that we can do with our flies and spiders by a whole lot. Just need 2 cents. Love to get Hive Mind. Also, of course, the added benefit of us having Keeper Sack and giving us, you know, stats for it. Which we are going to get. Bam. I could go all the way back to the to get that Eternal Heart, but we've got Isaac's Tomb, and it's going to pay out literally like every single time that we go to a new floor. So let's do it.
Spent it. It's gone. Just get over it.
It's gone. How could you have spent our savings?
Here we get our HP upgrade. Let's save the Ace of Hearts for something. Ooh, gold and crystal key. I mean, it's not really worth it anymore, but I'm going to take it anyway. Man, gold and crystal key. We're worried for this floor. Worried for this run. Think of all the Zane we could have had together. Would have been a match made in heaven. I think a haunt just disappeared in the sauce there. The crystal key gonna open up a red door. There's a very good chance at opening up a red door when it's the golden crystal key. The double chance. Wow, that is a lot of things. Whenever astral projection goes off, that is a lot of things. We basically should be able to get a red door in every room that one can spawn. Theoretically. Okay, we'll just get a tears up and an HP upgrade, sure. See here again the guaranteed Isaac's Tomb. No, you know what, I don't want crack key. Yeah, let me have some fun with the golden crystal key. We never get to see you. You don't call anymore, you don't show up to parties, you never log in and play Halo with me anymore. Oh, we got that mega bomb fly as our ally. That's going to be interesting.
You need to repent. You need to confess your sins and become saved. Let his light inside you cleanse your
you
soul.
Are insane. You are taking this way.
Hello, M. Now we'll take suplex. Yeah, buddy. I don't know what the heck that was, but I don't even want to know. Okay. Trickle charge? Nah. We got a beast to suplex. Oh yeah, brother. Oh yeah, brother. Okay, apparently there's a problem with suplex. Repentance. Repentance. All right, so word to the wise, don't use suplex. Suplex will apparently crash your game like every other room, apparently, I guess. Or maybe we have too much movement speed. I don't know, man. I'm still gonna try to suplex Beast no matter what. I don't even care. I mean, this doesn't matter. Even if we take damage, it doesn't matter. We've got Isaac's Tomb. Isaac's Tomb's gonna give us as much HP as we want. Wow, we got another Soul of Lilith. And man, am I glad we did. That's a lot of damage that we're doing with Kidney Stone procs. All right, finally home. Take a quick nap here, just a quick gander. And I gotta tell you, it's not gonna look good for Dogma. Dogma is in a lot of trouble here. Now, hopefully the game doesn't crash. If it does, then we're gonna have to fight Dogma all over again. Well, down goes the TV. Oh, yeah, brother! I don't know what I grabbed. Not sure what I grabbed there. Isaac grabbed something, and then he just completely froze. All right. Time for old Beastie. Oh, yeah! Yeah, piercing shots makes this very easy. Oh yeah, brother! That's impossible to not get hit there. Okay. Or said you will not be suplexing me. I did anyway, War. Suplex death. All right, it's the time you've been waiting for. Game, don't crash. Oh, yeah, brother. All right. All the horsemen and mother the beast has been properly suplexed. One more time, brother! Oh. We actually went underneath Beast. I didn't even know that was possible. For the dunk and the win! Oh, boy. Thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed that. Sorry about all the crashes. Yeah, be careful using Suplex, because apparently it can crash your runs right now. But if you enjoyed this video, make sure you click the like button. If you didn't, click the dislike button. Of course, subscribe and ring the notification bell if you have not already done so to join the Mosh Pit here on YouTube. I hope you had a fantastic start to your Friday. Stay tuned for the Thusmas VOD coming up at the 2 o'clock spot about maybe 40 minutes from now after this video ends. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like The Revenant, Chocolate Milk Guy, Maddie, Nathan Tollefson, Austin Parente, and Nicholas Fernald. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, then check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find over at patreon.com/Sinvicta.